Mobile internet retailing in India in 2015 grew at 183% in terms of value. This growth was driven by the increased use of smartphones, mobile applications, and the higher acceptance of mobile payments. Digital purchases sales generated by tablets, PCs, and mobiles together contributed a 60% growth in sales in 2015.
The rising aspirational needs of Indian consumers is attracting international brands to India, especially within the beauty and fashion industry. In 2015, we saw a number of international brands enter the Indian fashion market. American brands such as Gap and Aeropostale, Swedish brand H&M, and Brazilian pop luxury footwear brand Melissa opened their stores in India during 2015.
Asia's mobile retail industry is extremely dynamic. The Chinese mobile retail industry market size was $235 billion in 2015, while that of India's was $10.2 billion in the same year. Though the Indian market witnessed a real growth of 254% over the period 2010 to 2015. A burgeoning entrepreneurial segment and easy availability of venture capital has increased the number of tech startups and mobile apps.
In 2015, the Government of India announced its plans to reach the 50th ranking in Doing Business 2019 of the World Bank from 130th in Doing Business 2016, a feat which achieved would definitely bring in higher foreign investment. In order to do so, the government must simplify business procedures and make the tax environment a little less complicated. The government has worked towards this by introducing the Goods and Services Tax in 2016.
A smartphone in India is set to record a 26% volume growth year on year, which is going to be highest in Asia Pacific. This growth opportunity, clubbed with government initiatives like Make in India, makes it very lucrative for companies ranging from Foxconn to Celcom, and they all want to set up their manufacturing base in the country. By doing this, companies can enjoy low labor cost, savings in transportation cost, and savings in import duties. On the other side, consumers can reap the benefits of range of choices, better service support, and a price dip.
Over the next 2 years, hot drink manufacturers such as Tata Global Beverages will continue to launch premium varieties of green teas and coffee blends. These new launches, when coupled with continued preference for these products, will also drive value growth in hot drinks and make India one of the fastest growing regions in Asia Pacific. This will also increase the share of wallet for hot drinks, which is one of the lowest when compared to other beverages in India.
A consumer in India consumes twice the amount of sugar compared to a consumer in UK for every bottle of Sprite. The nutritional information reveals that it has 12% of sugars in India compared to only 6% in UK. Also, considering the fact that the diabetic prevalence in India stands at 8.7%, which is higher than global average of 8.3% in 2015, I would assume that the carbonate manufacturers in India should start looking at lowering the sugar content in 2016.
India is one of the fastest growing economies in the world, with a real GDP growth rate of 7.2% in 2015. In 2016, India is expected to surpass China's economic growth by reaching 7.3% real GDP growth rate. This growth will be driven by upcoming policy reforms, growth in investments, and low commodity prices.
Due to the ban by FSSAI, the instant noodle value sales in India recorded the fastest decline in the world at 49% in 2015. With the comeback of Maggi and other instant noodle brands, the market is recovering rapidly. In fact, the India instant noodle value sales will be the fastest growing market in Asia-Pacific region during the forecast period, with a value growth of 10% year-on-year in next 5 years.
Euromonitor's global consumer survey result shows that 64% of online consumers in India buy a product or service on their laptop or computer at least once in a month, and 58% of them buy it on their smartphones. Although we see both e and m-commerce booming in India, our hyperconnectivity survey result shows that consumers are not very loyal and keep switching on between devices and channels during their path to purchase for a wide variety of products. Online consumers commonly research on their smartphones, but when it comes to purchase, they prefer a laptop or computer, or even go in stores. And for some product categories like consumer electronics, they research in store and buy online.